Hello, and welcome once again to the Tasty Gang, all us lot together again. Me, Terry Kay. Welcome to the live tasting. I'm kind of all excited as usual. I'm gagging for it, I really am. We've got three beers up here. There's three behind them for next week. So we've got three beers here ready to go. The first one was one of the GBBF beers. I think it might be over now, so hopefully you got it before. Is that a leg back? Hold on. Yeah, hopefully you got it before the thingy. Let's get it up and live on the comments. Yeah, Williams Brothers. Absolutely excellent brewery. I'm going to pour this and yay, we've got them all commenting already. That's lovely. We've got someone says, hi, live tasters. Yeah, that's me, Nate. Beer Guru Reviews. Connie says, hi.
Hi.
Evil Badger says, hello there. Hello there. Jonathan Brown says, evening all. Evening all. And Derek says, hello, everyone. Hello. Lovely to see you in. That is lovely, lovely, lovely. Just refresh that while I'm getting this out now. I've got this one. The others I kind of kept pretty much at the same similar temperature as what they are. The parallel I put in the fridge, got it out about an hour and a half ago. This one I got out about 20 minutes, if that. So it's still chilly willy. I've got a little magic one. Look, this is my pint glass. That's my glass, these. You gotta love these. I've seen these up here. Look, pocket pint they're called. You can see there's still a bit of water in it where I've kind of, you wash it like that in there. Watch this. Look, this is brilliant. This is absolutely brilliant. Watch. There you go. Isn't that brilliant? Just pull it out, make sure it's all solid and firm and everything. And that's ready to go. Look at that pocket pint. Yeah, brilliant, isn't it? See, I love a gadget. I absolutely love a gadget, especially when one works. Speaking of gadgets, like, I've still got it, don't I? Whoa. Right. Let's crash that away and let's get going. Lovely bit of the old Williams Brothers. I do love them. Nice. Looking good. It ain't come over the top, as you actually said to the bishop. That's the old Williams Brothers crown there. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Beautiful, lovely, fantastic. Sexy, nutritious, and delicious. That's just me. Get commenting, guys. Get smelling. Get doing stuff. Hopefully. I bet no one's got this. I bet you all missed out on the GBBH beers. Oh, there we go. Hey. Hello. That's what it looks like. Nice kind of white head on there. Looks lager-like. It's the first time I've tried this. I'm hoping a lot of kind of craft brewers and things are getting into your lagers nowadays, I've noticed. You got Hogsback did a lager, best lager I've ever tried. Even better than my favourite for a long while, the old Niels Oscar. Gould. Oh, Gould, blimey. Gould lager. Meaning good lager in Swedish, is it? No, it ain't Swedish. Yeah, it is Swedish, yeah. Let's have a quick refresh on the comments, see what we've got. And we've got who else is live commenting tonight. Let's have a look. Hello, Terry and Tasters. That's Mickey. Mickey! I say Mickey! Beer Guru says, you're planning on having Halloween tasting in a few weeks. Pumpkin, I've already got a couple of Halloween-y type beers, but one of them's up here, would you believe? So it's a kind of preview to Halloween. I don't want to go too mad on it, because unless they come up with something new, you know, I've done a lot of the Halloween-y beers. But yeah, it's a good idea. And as I say, I've got a little preview one up there. What else we got? I had Williams one last week, 3.8, I mean. Yeah, I think it is. No, this is 5.0. Oh, I see. You had the other Williams Brother one. Hey, I think they had two. Was it Honey Badger? I think that was the one you were on about. I think they had Honey Badger in it. It was really nice. A weird name, Gunny. The Gunny. Yeah, Gunny No Do That. That one. Yeah, that was quite nice as well. I think they had Honey Badger in it as well. I think that was theirs. And all of their stuff is lovely stuff. Really, they're a good brewery. Kind of proper, honest brewery. Honest boys and that doing an honest job. And that's lovely, that is. Now, let's have a sniff on this. Let's see what we're getting. Ooh, it smells nice. It actually smells really nice. Parallel-like almost. It smells of more like Parallel or Marisotter malts rather than Pilsner malts and things like that, you know. There's a little bit of something. Down the side of the glass, from the middle, I'm not getting nothing, but as I come over the side of the glass, I'm getting grapefruits and lemons and stuff, you know. But a little kind of a little sweetie, kind of candy sweet of some sort, like these, the little ones you get, I don't know if yours was the same. We didn't, you know, when I was a kid and that, we didn't have many kind of like upmarket sweets. There was like the crap sort of Chewit, Penny Chewits and things and all that. But for some reason, when like the dad would be driving us down to wherever, you know, South End or something like that, lays down and all that, you know, proper upmarket holiday places. But be driving us down to some grotty caravan site in the Zephyr, and they'd have a expensive jar of sweets, a hard sweets, with some sort of pad of flour or icing sugar over them. But they were lovely, and it's kind of got a little reminder of that icing sugar stuff that was over them. Down the edge of that, it's lovely, that is. Right, let's have a little taste. Hold on, can't stop, whoa! Sorry, I've gone straight in, you know, voice. I've gone straight in. Like, yeah, I'm here, taste. Drink, smell it. I ain't even asked you guys, sorry, guys. I'll get too carried away and excited. I had William's Honey Thief last week. What do you reckon on it, Mickey? Do you reckon it's a good one? I liked it myself. As I said, I love all their beers. But I thought it was really nice. They had another honey beer one as well. Not them, was it Holden's or something? Someone else had a honey beer one. That was quite nice, but I think that was just a bit better. It's kind of it's a nice one. I think the other one was Lavender Honey from the Wolf Brewery. And that was nice as well. Very different. Smells good. Bit like Crafty Dan. Big juicy fruits. Yeah. I don't know if you've any of you's had that Crafty Dan. Look, I've got a spare one here. Look, that was you did. You had it with me, didn't you? That was that was lovely. We had it together last week, I believe. It's got those kind of on the bugle anyway. It's nice little sort of tropical fruits almost in the background, just a long way off. So that's kind of nice. Well spotted there, Derek. You know, till you said it, I think there was a little bit distant, a little bit kind of Quercus. Quercus smoked porter, yeah. I loved the two porters that was in it. The Quercus and the H something or other, H. Can't remember the H one. Had a big H on the front. Both of them was lovely. Really nice. It won't let me see you. Oh, really? Let's have a quick look. I can see me. What's happening? Is anyone else not being able to see my pretty face? You're probably putting your hands together if you can't. You're like, yeah, we can't see him, ugly chops. What else we got here? Right, I'm going to taste this because I've kind of got the feeling that a lot of you have either drunk yours already or couldn't get it this week. Was some lucky young lady was saying, "Cor, that's lovely. That is really lovely." As you said, it's actually quite similar to the Crafty Dan IPA there. Parallel. That's nice. Really nice. What was I saying? Do you know what? I can't remember. My brain's gone. Cor, that is nice. That really is lovely. Yeah, that's it. There was a young lady, like one of my commenters, and she said that that she works in Sainsbury's, and at the end of the when it comes to the voting's over and everything else at the GBBH beers in Sainsbury's, they sell them off to the staff stinking cheap, you know what I mean, like just for £1 each and stuff like that, and silly money. That's ridiculous. I'd have them. But yeah, they take loads of them home. Suitcase, like, cases full of them for, like, silly money in it, you know. Yeah, there you go. There's a fiver. Have a case. Last time I had something like that was I was working one of my millions of different jobs that I've had was working in Hedges and Butler that do the packaging of beers and things and spirits and whatever else and kind of bottling up stuff. And they used to kind of sell off loads of stuff, cases full of stuff for silly money, like I say, like £5 a case and £3 a case and stupid money at the end of the weeks and that. And it was brilliant. It's perks of the job. Lovely stuff. Right, let's get a bit more of this down and tell you what I'm getting here. Let's have a quick look, see what the others are getting. Beer Guru says, it's fine, I can see you. Agreed, Quirkus was lovely. Pardon me. Mickey's tasting peachy. Yeah, it is kind of peachy, kind of like a little fruit cocktail, these tropical fruits, you know, things like mangoes and peaches and pineapples, little bits and bobs. Love the black pepper. I wasn't mad on the black pepper one. It was a nice little kind of gimmick with the little pouch of black pepper in there. But I think they should have had more black pepper. I ended up chucking a load of my own in here. And it was like, oh. But it kind of did do something for the beer as well. So it wasn't just for a gimmick, but it's, you know, I don't know. I think there was more gimmick than actual substance. I think you could have put the pepper in the beer rather than after, you know. Where are we? Honey Thief was lovely. Yep. Mickey says Honey Thief was lovely. Good. What else we got? Right, let's give you a few notes what I'm getting you. Oh, that's lovely. As Derek, it's quite, for lager, it's quite resiny, quite chewy almost. And as Derek says, you definitely got peach in there. Nice wet peach when it all runs down your hand and you're like, ooh. Animal, I know. But, giving all my games away. But yeah, nice peach. And the same as on the nose, you're getting those tropical fruits in there as well, a bit of pineapple. Tiny little hints of mango as well. But that, if you've ever had something like a Brooklyn Lager, that's quite fruity. That's like a Brooklyn Lager turbocharged. That's kind of and it's, what we're talking, 5%. It tastes bigger than 5%. All those hops really going in there, quite rich, quite big. And it tastes dry hopped with something. Maybe something summity or something like that. Nelson Sorbin or something. Great Glasgow band and a great name for a beer. We coax. Oh, coax. Coax. We coax the amazing aromas out of the New Zealand and Slovakian hops. So that New Zealand one is possibly a Nelson Sauvin. You've got a kind of like a little gooseberry sort of taste coming off there. Blonde with an eclectic bunch of light malts and cold conditioning on an infusion of cone hops. Yeah, they're kind of chucked in there, big and resiny, probably quite late. With fresh pressed strawberries. Oh, well. Strawberries as well in there. That is nice. That really is nice. Massively fruity. Excuse me, picking my nose there. It's not nothing. It's a bit of air. It's gone up the wrong way again. Massively fruity. Really lovely. I'm going to have a quick refresh before I drink this up. See what anyone's got to say. Open your next one, boys. Get a sniff. Boys and girls, I should say, because we do get ladies watching as well. A pleasant bitterness, says Mickey. Tastes peachy. Yep, dead right there, Mickey. A pleasant bitterness, more of a pale ale. Yeah, kind of. I'm thinking along them lines myself. But in the same way that you got Brooklyn Lager, pardon me, it's quite fruity. I think you can extend that a little bit without it being a pale ale, because it's probably brewed with the bottom feeding yeast, and it's kind of a slower conditioned one and slower fermented and everything else. So you can, me personally, I've always thought a great way of going about it is doing a kind of dirty lager and that, you know, doing a kind of lager with ale yeasts, get it done quicker, use the same sort of, you know, use hops that are like Fuller's Summer Ale, they use Czech hops and everything else, light malts and all that, so you can use pills and malts, light malts, all sorts. Quicker turnover in it. Will you miss the kind of slower, longer conditioning? I don't know, don't think so. Maybe in the lighter beers, the very light beers. Anyway, that is absolutely beautiful. I can't really taste massive strawberry in there. I'd love to see what it tastes like with the strawberry taken out and see if there's any difference, see if it's worth its, you know, worth its money. Sometimes you don't actually taste it, but they add a lot of, you know, a lot to them. So, have you got your other beer open, boys and girls? What have we got? Get your sniffers on the other one. It's the iPad feed, me thinks. Have a good one, lads. You going off again, Connie? Paul? You've gone off there, Reverend Bus? Dear, oh dear. It's all going tits up for people. Interesting beer glasses. Yeah, I love these little beer glasses. Little pocket ones. And they do. They're pretty good. It's holding it. And if it don't hold it, you've got a little coaster underneath. For any tiny bits that might make it through. But I find in on most of these, there's one I think I had that was a little bit kind of loose and that, and it was coming through very, just slightly. Saying that, it's probably this one. Oh, that is really lovely. Right, I'm going to get on to the next one. Really loving it. Next one is, as you see, the old Tribute Cornish Pale Ale. Pale Ale. So that Reverend Buzz says Beer Guru Reviews. Yeah, I think he's in need of something. Speaking of something new, guys, bit of advice needed. Always kind of shy away from asking for phone advice, because next thing you know, you get every Tom, Dick and Harry and mad spammer in the world kind of going, yeah, this phone. I'm not interested in buying a phone or buying any form of whatever, and, you know, tariffs, this and everything else, because I've already got it. I've already got the the whole package and everything else. But I've got Xperia, a Sony Xperia Z1, I think it is, and I think it's Z1, and I'm a bit troubled on how to do a Google Plus Hangout on it. I know how to do a Hangout if you invite someone in, but how do you do just a broadcast one? Does anyone know? If you do, let me know. Right, Tribute. Cornish Pale Ale. Pale Amber in colour. Tribute is Moorish. Moorishly drinkable beer with delicious, full-bodied malt flat. Hold on, blah, 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 blah. Cornish Walter. Cornish Golden Marisotto malts. Lovely. With a hand-picked blend of aromatic hops. What does that mean? A hand-picked blend of aromatic hops. So are they actually hand-picked? Because I know you can get most hops now are picked with a machine. Back in the day, many people you speak to, if they're, you know, of a certain age and that, they'll remember going hop picking. you know, in Kent and wherever else. If you ever go a-hopping, a-hopping down in Kent, you wish you never went. Aromatic hops. It's truly Cornish pale ale. There you go, pale ale. And they've done that lovely thing of including a little list of ingredients that says Maris Otter, pale malt, spring water, Cornish spring water, Cornish gold malt, Fuggles, Willamette, and stewing golden hops. And, of course, our own brewer's yeast. That, I so love that. Just a little, we ain't asking for the recipe. You ain't giving no games away by doing that, you know. Let's get the glass ready here. Ready? You ain't giving no games away by doing that, you know. And it makes it much more interesting because what happens is, that's it. What happens is that the more you drink different things and you start to taste different hops, you become, whether you want to or not, you become educated about the hops. And you start to go, oh, well, I tasted that one before and I love that taste. And instead of talking about things like, tastes peachy, it tastes so-and-so, you end up saying, yeah, it tastes a bit like citra, doesn't it? Things like that. And they become another ingredient, the same as apples or carrots or whatever, you know. There's the St. Austell. And brewing since, when does that say, 1930, what was it? Can't see it on the bleeding little label there. 1850, is it, or something? Who knows? It don't matter. Let's pour that and get cracking. I really must stop jabbering on. I get passionate about the old beers in there and I start yabby 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 yabby. Right, let's see what you guys have got to say about this. That looks lovely. Looks really beautiful. Nice and golden. Golden and gifted. Ready to go. What have we got saying here? Oh, good lads. Got a few people saying a few things here now. Oh, here we go. Interest green glass, yep. Taste pretty. A pleasant bitterness, more of a pale. Oh, that was already here. Got my Adnams ready. It'll be early. Adnams are a brilliant brewery. We're not on the Adnams yet. Biscuits, biscuit, not a whole lot on the nose though. Adnams Broadside is a good one. Yeah, we've got the Southwold at the moment. But yes, Jonathan, yep. Right, so let's have a sniff of this. Now, straight away, you're getting a lovely little edge of Fuggles. Come down the edge of the glass there. Well, pardon me, excuse me. Little Fuggles, the earthy, golden, lovely, lovely little sexiness coming down the side of the glass, like a little bitter thing waiting for it. Quite subdued on the aromas there, as Evil Badger says, quite subdued, nice and biscuity. You are right dead bang on there with that. Kind of those rich tea biscuits, but almost like they've been dipped in lemonade. Does that sound a good idea? You know, instead of your tea, someone's giving you, or lemon tea, something like that. You've got a lemon tea, and then you've dipped it in, getting in there with it. Yeah. That sounds a bit better than lemonade, doesn't it? I can't help it. What else? Any other little aromatics there? Hey, Endgamer's in with us. Endgamer says, I haven't opened the Adnams yet. I should add, yeah. That's true. Right, Adnams Gun Ale is great. Yeah, I think most of the Adnams beers are pretty good, you know. You know, they've been, over the years, they've been the saviour. I've always said this, that they've been one of the saviours of kind of real ales and that. You know, when it was kind of a bit unfashionable almost to have real ales. Now it's becoming a fashionable thing, you know, all the rock bands and the boyos and things like that, you know, they're all getting into the real ales now. and no one's going getting shameful about, oh, I'm real old. And, you know, you get still get your idiots. Look, excuse me if you're a football supporter and that, but you, what I call your football shirts, you still get your idiot football shirts, you know, tattooed truckwits and whatever, excuse me, whatever else, you're in your big screen pubs. I only drink Carlsberg, right? Usually standing up the bar like that, puffing their chest out. Walking around like with their chin like that, you know. I've seen enough of them back in the day when I used to do doors and things like that. That smells nice. I'm gagging the game with this one. I'm going to give you just a quick one. And ball sounds good and drinking. Proper job. Proper job. That's lovely. You want to try the big job, Unsigned Melodies. You want to try the big jobby. The big job. Oh, that is beautiful. Proper job with a bit of turbo boost. So let's one more quick refresh and see what anyone's got to say on this. Don't be shy, lads. You know, get in there. Get in there, get in there. Adnams Innovation, that's another good one. Yeah, Innovation. I think that was the first one brewed with the light bottles, in the lighter bottles. 33% less glass and all that. And they've got the new brewery thing now where they've got grass growing on the roof and everything. It insulates and also does all sorts of other things. I think they filter out their own water and stuff now. Ghost Ship. Ghost Ship is great too. Ghost Ship on cask is nice, on bottles a bit nicer, but in can, wow, in can is beautiful, really is, very American like in can, big citra hops all sitting in there, dry hopped, right, you know, beautiful stuff. Right, let's tell you what I'm getting off of the old tribute here. What are we talking, ABV 4.2, so very sessionable, so let's have a see if it tastes sessionable. On my landlord, and said he might be getting a barrel of Tally Ho. That's beautiful. I've just recently done, I'm sorry, I'm going off here again. Just recently did done a vertical tasting, kind of, not like that, you know, a vertical tasting, like different years of Tally Ho. So I've done, I did a Tally Ho review, which about to release soon. And I've also got different years of it as well. And I think they changed one hop on different years and whatever. I think they do, if I remember rightly. Anyway, let's get this down. Cheers, guys. Chin chin. Bottoms up. Nostrovia and Slanchy and everything else. Cheers. Cool. Oh. That wants more of you, didn't it? Cool. Oh, that's bloody lovely. Honey-like. You got those hints of honey. I'd swear they had honey in it. But there's hints of honey in it. Pulling at you, it's like, pulling you into the glass. Really lovely. That's dangerously sessionable. That is really, really lovely. Went in there for a little, and it's like, what we got? Have you not got these beers? Am I talking to myself here, am I? Ghost Ship cans, yummy. You're absolutely right. Yeah, they really are. You've got to go for, try a side by side. You know, get a Ghost Ship and what do they call that? A parallel tasting, I think, or something like that. But get Ghost Ship and get in a bottle and get a Ghost Ship in the can. You see the difference. Massive. Massive difference. Go ship. Just have a quick one more go. Having Broadside on Saturday. I'll be a guru. Connis, he seems to be able to plan all his beers in advance. I kind of think that's kind of an amazing thing to be able to do, because I can't even plan my next toilet break. I can't. I usually sit here with a nappy on. But that was just like, no trousers, just let it wander on the floor. If you're splashing lately, you know what it is. Yes, Southwold next. So get your Southwold ready, because I'm going to finish this one off in a minute. I'm going quite quick tonight. Sweating like a bleeding glass blower's ass. Broadside in bottles knocks the pence off the cask. I've not tried that, Dil. I'm going to have to try that, because I think I've tried a few of the Adnams ones. I've tried quite a few, but I don't think I've tried the broadside. So I'm going to have to try that one. But yeah, people get kind of a bit cask poncy in that, a bit cask kind of snobbery in a way, you know, and people, there are quite a lot of people, especially in kind of camera world and things like that, and anything you say, oh, it's better on cask, and you go, well, have you tried it on Ken? No, I haven't, but it's better on cask. Well, how can you tell? How can you tell? And I find that it's about 50-50. It's half the time it's better in bottles, half the time better in cask. And there's other ways of having things. I mean, keg. People keg like that. And pasteurised beers and things like that. Like, yeah, you get all sorts of beers, and some are nice in... Beer is nice in all sorts of genres. Keg. Honeydew. Honeydew on keg, or in keg, I think was much better than cask. But in cask is so dependent on who's looking after it. And if you get a good cellarman, he can do 2/3 of the job of the brewer. He can really make that beer that he's got coming to him, really make it shine. He can really, really make it, bring it to the best of its ability that the brewer casked it at, you know. And a lot of pubs, they can't seem to do that. They seem to mess something up along the way. Anyway, let's get this down. Oh, that is lovely. I'm going to have another little drop of that. Cool. That is superb, that is, really is. I think that's, I've underestimated that. When I bought it, I thought, oh, that'll be nice. And for some reason, whatever, it's got better than the last time I reviewed it, or just my memory's changed or something, I think sometimes your taste changes slightly. I go through little spells of wanting this type of beer or that type. And at the moment, that is just, God, that is calling and singing to me. Come in for more. I don't think I could be safe with a dozen of them sitting in a box and that. If I bought a dozen of them, they'd be like, oh, come on, Tell, come on. Starting out for one. Cheers, everyone. Oh, burpee, though. That is the trouble with these carbonated beers. Ones that ain't kind of bottle conditioned. Bottle conditioned carbonation seems to release itself before it goes in the stomach. You know, it's kind of, and also it goes in smoother, less bitey. And that can be good, can be bad sometimes. Sometimes you want a bit of that carbonic acid, giving it that, to perk the drink up a little bit. But a lot of the time, I just like it smoother. And the trouble with some of these beers, you drink, especially if you drink them quick for a review, you drink it down, you're like, burp, burp. People go, why are you burping so much, you disgusting oaf? There you go. Cheers, everyone. That is beautiful. Right. Open with me next one. If I can get it open, here we go. You know what you do to wash these up as well? You put some water in, a little dib of fairy liquid, like that, and then you get it open again. Right, wash it under the tap, put a bit more water in just on its own, and that's it, it's your washing up done. And you leave it on the side to dry out. That one's not fully dried. But you just pull them out like that, just make sure you pull them tight all the way out, flick it out like that, and that's it, ready and raring to go. Adnams, Southwold Bitter, get it open, boys, tell me what you're getting. Hopefully you got this one, because this is available everywhere. Well, I think so anyway. Tell us what you're getting, guys, on the nose. By the way, as I keep saying, tell, you know, everyone in your forums and things, you know, you're going on the, see, a lot of you know me also from Facebook and things and Twitter and things like that. So tell anyone that's into the beers, tell them to get on here, because I want to see it picking up. Because don't get me wrong, I really enjoy our little chats together, but we need a few more in as well. I think. I don't think we need it too busy. We don't want like 400 going whoosh, whoosh with the comments, but we need a few in so the comments kind of run down a little bit. So let's have a look. Thanks for the compliment, Tel. Oh, you're all right, mate. You're most welcome. See, I don't like to compliment for no reason. So, you know, I always think if someone's kind of got it right or doing a good job or talking sense or anything like that, you know, and then I believe in saying, yeah, good stuff and all that. Where are we? Aroma, grassy and floral. Oh, right. You started without me. Let's get going on this. Yep. Lovely, lovely crown. They're doing something with the crown. Nice to see that always. Because I collect crowns. And to this day, I've been collecting every single one that I've done on video review anyway. On video review, and still I don't know the word for a collector of crowns. I know there's the labia, whatever it is, labia phallicis or something, labia phallus or something like that. He's a collector of the labels. Then you've got Bruiana, he's like a collection of anything to do with beers and that. But I know, I'm pretty sure, I've seen it on QI or something like that, a collector of the bottle crowns, bottle caps and that. What's that called? And I'm about to have people say, yeah, it's a labia or whatever it is. Excuse me, told you. Oh, we've got people on the taste notes now this time. Let's have a look. Oh, man, I've got proper burps and racing that now. Right, let's have a look. Let's pour this out. Sorry if I sound a bit racy tonight. But I kind of I've got my head around the idea of doing faster reviews. And for some reason, it's made me speak faster. I mean, I speak fast when I'm kind of excited anyway. I'd never be able to play poker. I'd be like, okay, next one, I'll be going. They go, yeah, fold. I'll go, no. And it'd be this if I'm a bit disappointed in the end. I just wouldn't be able to play. Right? They go, right, bet. Let's have a sniff. Twirl it. Ooh. Right, what are we getting? Aroma, grassy and floral. Bang on it there, Connis. Bang on it, mate. Grassy, floral, and I'm kind of getting a bit earthy as well. Kind of earthy in a nice way, in a mushroomy sort of stew kind of way. When you add a bit of the old that brown stuff, brown powder stuff, the nutmeg. No, a little bit nutmeggy. But kind of an older nutmeg, not a fresh ground stuff. The powder stuff you get in the thing. Pour it in your stew to give it that little earthy edge. And it's lovely when you get a stew with a bit of that in it. Earths it up a bit. Beautiful. Rustic. Where are we? Tetley Smooth is better on cask. Tetley Smooth? I think that's the Cairns. God, blimey. I've not tried it on cask, but the Cairns... Not mad on the cans, so it must be better on cask. I don't think I'd really want to try that out either way. I'd have to try it now you've said it, you know, but, you know. It's a kind of a bit of a muck ale, that one. But not amazing either way, yeah. I think I might leave that one. Beer Guru reviews for Adnams, I mean the aroma. Oh, right, hold on, where are we? I think I probably got what you were saying anyway. No, you said aroma, didn't you? All right. Anyway. Marmalade notes. Let's have a little go. Hold on. Let's twirl it. Ooh. It's hard to twirl in these glasses. They're quite kind of slopey edges. They don't come like that, so you can throw it back in the glass on itself. Yeah, kind of a burnt orange. Like a burnt orange sort of edge to that. So, yeah, possibly when you're cooking up the oranges for marmalade, add M&S bitter once. In small writing on the label said Adam Southwold. Yeah, I love when they do that. It's occasionally they might change one of the malts or something just to make it a different one. I think Schiehallion and M&S, is it M&S? It might be Tesco Craft Lager or something. It's one of the Craft Lagers, Sainsbury's Craft Lager or something or other. It's basically Harvest and Schiehallion. But I think they use Maraschino instead of Parallel Malt or something along them lines. Very, very little difference. And basically, it's the same beer in it, you know. Hints of caramel. Yeah, I'm getting a little bit of that. Again, kind of burnt little edges, sort of burnt toast and burnt caramel edges. So if you was kind of making your own toffee apples and things like that, you get sort of little burnt drips now and again, here and there. Like that. Chistel, drinking a few along with you. Nice to see you, Lewis. Nice to see you, mate. And let's have a little sniff here. As it's warming in the glass, for some reason you're getting more caramel in there. You're getting a nice little toffee, little edges, fudgy edges. Right, guys, I'm going in. I may be some time. Cheers. Oh, no, that proper honest bitter 4.1 ABV. Oh, throat's a bit funny, yeah. 4.1 ABV, so lovely jubbly. Let's just have a quick look here. Don't want to get too much on the taste notes, gives you a chance to get in. Tell me what you're getting, boys and girls. Tell me what you're getting. Hints of caramel. Drink the one along with you. All right. By the way, next week, we've got a cloudy, a dry, and a pump. So we've got an old rosy, cloudy cider. That, by the way, if you kind of... looking at it and thinking, oh, it looks a bit funny, all cheese, peas and carrots in the bottom and everything else, don't worry, go for it. You've got to try that out. That's beautiful. That's 7.3 on the Richter scale, that is. Savannah Dry, I'm going to say nothing about that. Premium cider, I ain't going to say nothing premium. Hold on. Pumpkin, one of the kind of Halloween beers. I found last year's one not as good as the year before. Distinctly lacking of pumpkin. 3.8 on the old Richter scale, and I'm sure it was bigger than that before. I think it was 4 point something. So it's going in the opposite direction a bit. It's going down a bit, but hopefully I'm noticing some of the Marsden beers and that, some of their beers, they're kind of coming back up again. They're getting as if they've sorted out a few problems and they're kind of getting back on the scene again, or getting, you know, sorting the recipes out and that, and getting them balanced again. So hopefully this time round they'll be lovely. I might do that before the others, funny enough. I might do them in the other order. That's what I might do, in that order. I think I might do them like that. And leave the biggie tool last. And then that one, then a sort of cidery, apple-y and all that business is following it. And then on we go. So, drink this. Let's get a few more taste notes out of yous and we'll drink it down. And I'll say a biddly boo to yous and everything else then. As usual, guys, absolute pleasure. Absolute pleasure. I really like this. I don't know why, I just... You kind of don't get a chance to just sit down with mates and have a beer and kind of talk beer. You know what I mean? It's always like, yeah, let's talk about football, let's talk about, I don't know, something else, crap and whatever. Let's talk this, let's talk that. And you kind of go, well, let's talk beer. And they go, no, we're not interested. We like our lager. Yeah, where are we? Sorry, that was me. Cheers, tell drink, run along with you. I'm in, ha ha ha. Oh, he's back in again. Old Paul's back in, old Reverend Bus. I'm in! Ha ha ha! Good, good. He's finally got his iPad sorted out. Good, good. Well done. Endgamer says, the taste is lovely. Yum. Slight roasted nuts. Oh. Oh. Whoa, whoa. Let's have a little taste here, because I think you might be bang on it. Roasted nuts, bready, hint of biscuit and some citrus. Mate. Let's have a go. I think you could be doing reviews yourself here next week. Oh, that is summing it up in one line. That is. Why do I spend so long messing about on my reviews? That is right on the button. Stick a few currency in there with that, and that's right on the button. Bready, I'd sort of say a bit toasty, lightly toasty bread. You know, no, fresh kind of out of baker's when it's still yeasty a little bit. When you still got that hints of yeast and it ain't quite gone solid yet, you know. You can't bite into it because it's hot. And it's not going to be solid yet. Wait for it to cool down a bit and you're like, oh, hold on, I'll pull the middle out on the way home and that, you know. Slightly roasted notes, ready, hints of biscuit, bang on, bang on, bang on, and some citrus, yeah, bit of mixture of citrus, you got a little hint of lemon, bit of pith, and a bit of something, bit of grapefruit, and a bit of something orangey or tangerine-y, sort of blood orange maybe, something kind of a more floral kind of orange. Not quite bergamot-y sort of orange, but something either a blood orange or tangerine, some one way or the other. But that's lovely, isn't it? That's lovely. I like the dry sort of background finish you got on there. There must be some sort of Fuggles or Southdown or something on there. What does it say? Copper-coloured beer. Nope. Come on, Adams, what are you doing here? You ain't going to let the side down. The others have listed their hops. Listen, I'm sure this is not falling on deaf ears when I keep saying about listing the hops, because I've noticed. And us little guys, we do get heard, you know. I've noticed that when I'm keeping on going about it, there's more people who are listing their hops nowadays. Saying that, they haven't. Old Fergus saying, ain't got around to telling them yet. Nope, I can't see it on there. There's loads of different like countries' writings and things, but nothing about hops. And I really say, look, it's you're not giving your recipe. I'm tongue-tied. Not giving a recipe away, just let us know about what hops. One more quick refresh to see what you guys are thinking of. Mickey says, good on you, Rev. Hey. Beer Guru Review says, I'm getting caramel too. Yep. Oh, and some caramel. Yes, yes. Bang on. Definitely roasted malty notes. Yeah, roasted. You kind of, it's as if I think you've probably got a bit of dark malt in there of some sort. Because there's that burnt toast edge to it. That little tiny burnt toast edge. That's very nice. Almost coffee-like, on like astringent sort of burnt thing. Just heat adding away there. And that's why I'm kind of thinking probably something like Fuggles in it, pardon me, with a dark malt just going in there. And separating out between those and the parlour malts. Separating out to make it a little bit more complex, considering it's just a simple drinking beer, you know. a kind of what, you know, one of these hard working solid beers that you can get a good session going with. Oh, excuse me. It's your ear rolls. You get that when you get older. Definitely. Oh, right, what's on that? I don't know. Well, guys, one last quick. I was given a bottle of White Stout. Oh, you lucky sod. Durham White Stout, one of the finest beers you can get. It really is a beauty. Mickey, you've got to drink it while the hops are still banging and lively. Because being a hoppy beer, it won't age. You know, well, yeah, someone will tell me otherwise, but I think you probably won't get it at its, you won't get it at its best if you kind of keep on hold of it for too long. Grassy taste, says Connie's there, beer guru. Mmm. Yeah, nicer. Nice, kind of, yeah, you get that grassy sort of taste in with the dark caramel notes, and it's really nice. Hobgoblin was beautiful until recently. Yeah, up until kind of the takeover by Marsden and that, and it went downhill. But as I said, I've noticed the Marsdens are coming up, you know, really coming up at the Durham Brewery tomorrow. Oh, you lucky sod, says Jonathan Brown. Gonna get me some White Stout. Yeah, you got to get that. Say hello to them from me, by the way. They're really, really good people down there, and they so know about brewery. They really do brewing, I should say. This is a bit sulfurous on the nose. See, that'd be the Burton Snatch. You got I think it's they've been moved from wherever they was brewing in Wychwood. I think they've been moved to Marsden's, which is on Burton on the Trent, isn't it? And you got what you call the Burton Snatch, and it's a sulfites in the water and things, in the water around there. And that gives a little bit of a thing. It misleads people sometimes. You get quite a few Marsden beers are in clear bottles, and people immediately, if they, I was nearly just going to say, if they don't know any different, That sounds a bit poncy. It's kind of if they're kind of just listening to knee jerk reactions, and that, you know, it's they straight away just think clear equals skunky. Yeah, that's it. That's the only thing that goes in the mind, and everything else is blocked. Well, no, I'm not listening. It doesn't. You know, clear it doesn't equal skunky. It all depends on who's looking after the beer bottles. And you've also got to think, how many have I had out of clear bottles that have been skunky? You know, how many have I had out of brown bottles that have been skunky? How many have I had out of bottles that have been skunky? Personally, you've seen me have nearly 1,000. Well, you've seen me have over 1,000 beers, because sometimes I do 2 or 3 in reviews and things like that. But you've seen me having 1,000 beers. I've drunk thousands more. So I've been drinking all my life thousands of beers, trying this bottle, that bottle, and all sorts of different bottles. And I had maybe 2 handfuls of skunky beers tops. And always looked after my beers. If I get beers from a supermarket or something, I reach around, I have a bit of a reach around, you know, pull something from behind. that sounded rude, didn't it? If I get them from a shop, I'll take it back and say, wait, that's a skunker. And if he goes, no, I'll just say, okay, I won't bother buying them here anymore, and just completely boycott the shop. But most of the time, unless you go in there and pick one out of a shelf that's on the corner right near the window, you know, it's common sense just says don't go for them dusty ones up near the window and that, you know. And you'll be safe. Supermarkets usually I've got a big, fast turnover, so they don't often get a chance to be skunky. And also, in supermarkets, over the aisles and that, a lot of the time, they've actually got UV filters over the lights and that. Their big window has got UV filter over it as well. So it's all clever stuff. Let's have a... Oh, beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Right, Sam, have a finish off. Ooh, it's poor rest, ain't it? Sorry, guys. Guys, gotta say, guys, I don't think we've got any girls in. But any of the ladies that sit and watch this in quiet without commenting, for one, comment. What's the matter with yous? Don't be shy. We need the ladies in because the ladies kind of keep us under control a little bit. We all get shy then. Shut up and behave ourselves. But let's have a little down there one. Guys, I'll see yous next week. See yous next time with a pumpkin, Witchwood pumpkin, Savannah Dry, and an old Rosie. Should be able to get them here, there, and everywhere. I'm pretty sure you can get me here, there, and everywhere. But let me know. Any suggestions as well? Suggestions I'm talking about, kind of, you can get beer, your favourite beers and that. And, pardon me, you can get your favourite beers, and then other people go, well, I can't get that. And you go, well, I can, just down the road. But it's kind of a bit more regional. But sort of, if you look on kind of things like the Asda's website and whatever, have a look down there. Give us a few sort of suggestions for beers that we can get from somewhere like Asda's. I've got a bad memory. I really have got a terrible memory. So you guys, like, say to me, tell this one, that one, because I'm sure one of those that we've just done, we've done before. I'm sure we did. But that, well, it doesn't matter. We enjoyed it again. But yeah, give us suggestions. And I ain't saying for definite, that I'll take them on board. Well, I will take them on board, but that we'll do them. But I'll take them on board for certain. Broadside is a high ABV 6.3. We ain't just had the Broadside, have we? No, Southold. Yeah, I think it is, yeah. Trying to think what the bottle looks like. Similar sort of thing, but I'm trying to think. That's the one with the little cannons, isn't it? Is it? I think that's the one with the little cannons. I'm sure it is. Guys, been a pleasure. I'm gonna do something in 1 minute. 1 fruity, one kind of biscuity. You gotta try things like, what the bloody hell? You gotta try things like that now and again. Just have a little mix now and again. The purist and that will be barking at the bleeding screen now. What are you doing? What are you doing? But there you go. And I've got my hip sway as well in there. I think that was the hip sway, yeah, it was. I think of those three, that hip sway was absolutely glorious. Really was. I think that was my favourite there. Guys and girls, just one more quick refresh there and have a look. By all means, chat on between yous. Always have a chat between yous. When we get off of the thing, you can actually, I don't know if you can still reply to someone, but when you get off, I know you can, when it all goes to normal, and you can have a reply to someone. You can go boom, reply to this one, reply to that one, or just leave your things at the top and with someone's name or whatever, or just chat amongst each other. By all means, carry on chatting, when I get off. And sometimes I even join you myself in that, I've got to get ready for tomorrow, though, tonight, so I'll be off, because I'm going to be judging tomorrow in the Midlands Seba Beer, what is it? Midlands Regional Finals in the BS. So I'm judging that tomorrow. So I'm going to be off, getting myself ready, getting things sorted, getting this ready, that ready, and everything else, So I shall see you all next week. Quick, where are we? Quick, have a quick see what anyone's got to say. It's a lovely British beer, says Mickey. Yeah. It is a lovely, and I love the British beers. I do sing the praises of all sorts of beers, but when you get British ones, I kind of get a big proud little lump in me throat when I get a good British brewery like Williams Brothers and Harveston's and Fuller's and things like that coming a bit further south, Adnams and stuff like that, Green King even, you know, people like that, they're good British breweries that are doing a good, fine, honest job. I'll get a lump in my throat and puff my chest out. Yes, we can take on the world, you know. We can. Yeah, I'm broadside. Just got it all wrong this week. Whoops. White stout, never tried it, sounds nice. Yeah, so a bit of an oxymoron stout. Usually you kind of think of stouts as black, you know. And really it's a stout like a stout-hearted man, a stout, you know. It just means strong as well as big. It meant kind of strong as well. And it's the language bastardized in the different directions and everything else. And stout became either fat or it became black drink, you know. Excuse me. But you could have a stout IPA. You could have all sorts of stout. And white stout was kind of just a white stout. It's kind of a light coloured malts, but it's highly malted and highly hopped as well. Nice balance, really lovely. Broadside, I said that. How about a McLager review? No, that's just cruel. Shall we do them? The only trouble with McLagers, unless you go, you can get them in the off license, you can buy them in singles, but most of the time, you know, you go down your supermarket, you have to buy four of them. Jesus Christ. You buy four of them and you're looking at the others going, oh, what a waste. You know, I've got to pour these on, you know, down the toilet. Yeah. It upsets me buying them as well, but just for the laugh 1 week. It's a good idea for a laugh. But, oh, no. I can't face drinking free. Oh, Jesus. It's an idea, I suppose. Or McLager, McAle, and a McCider. Maybe something like that. But there you go. At least we've got something different then, you know. Otherwise, McLager's all the fucking same. Excuse me, I didn't mean to swear, but there you go. I've got Muck Tourette's. Mickey says, can't remember the last skunky beer I had. Must be years ago. Yeah, and yet people are, oh, no, skunky, you know. And I think it's a mistake for Marsden's to do clear glass. I mean, I've got to praise them for doing it because it's like FU world and all that, you know, and a couple of fingers or even a finger or whatever you want up to the world, a finger of head or whatever. It's a finger of heads to the world in that, you know. That sort of thing, you know, it's kind of, yeah, we ain't listening to all you use kind of like knee jerks and that, you know. We're kind of listening to people that have drunk loads of beers and gone, what are you on about? That sort of thing. What other beers would you recommend from Durham Brewery? There's quite a few in there that are lovely, good, honest beers, but really, for me, I mean, you've got to go with that white stout. I just can't get over how good that is. That is one of those really take on the world, this is a brilliant beer, you know, one of those sort of beers. I've got a little playlist down in the old on the old page there. Wonderful, extraordinary, something fantastic, whatever beers is called. It's kind of self-explanatory. But go down there. And as I said before, if you're checking down it and you see any doubles, let me know. Or if you see any that where you think, hold on, you've reviewed so-and-so beer and that ain't even on here. Say to me, tell, what about so-and-so? And I'll go, ah, I don't like it. Or something like that. Or I might go, oh, yeah. You know, usually we'll probably, oh, yeah. Because my brain just don't work. It really don't. Works on things to do with beer, but it's kind of organisation and stuff. I'm lost. I need someone to organise stuff. Sounds like a lot for you. You would say that. Foster's, Anakin and Stella. Oh, no. I can't do it. You bastards. You're evil. Mickey says, Durham are great. Also try Whalen. One of them. I don't think I've ever had that one, so I can't Wynnum. You mean the brewery, didn't you? No, can't comment on that one. I had to look up the word comment on there. It's like leave a comment. I'm not constant brain's gone. Right, guys and girls, absolute pleasure. I really didn't want to leave yous tonight. That's why I've kind of lagged on a bit at the end. Really great pleasure seeing yous and chatting with yous. Really enjoyed it. Yeah, really enjoyed having a chat. Nice beers, really lovely beers. The Hip Sway, though, if you've missed out on that tonight, you've missed a blinding gorgeous, lovely beer. That is lovely. So let me know what you reckon for well, the week after. Let me know. But there's the beers for next week. As I say, well, I'll cut to the quick at the end of it. If you're ever looking to see what's next week's, Pumpkin, Savannah, Old Rosie. See you next time. Don't be late. I will start without you. Take care, guys. Biddly boo. Bye bye. Why have I done that? I look. That's the. No, I'm not even ready to end it now. Here we go.